Greetings, friends. David Marks here. In this video, I will teach you everything that I have learned about this mind-blowing new way to hide unwanted items from our photographs. In this tutorial, I'll show you some examples where Generative Remove does incredible work, and I'll explain some of the quirks of this new AI-powered tool. Before we get going, let me make it clear that this tutorial is for you cloud-based Adobe Lightroom users. I have a separate tutorial elsewhere for you Lightroom Classic users. If you're ready to learn something extraordinary, then let's jump right in and let's get started. With the new Generative Remove tool, we can make an unwanted element like this disappear without leaving Adobe Lightroom. To make that person vanish, I'm going to open up the Remove panel by clicking on this eraser icon. Next, I'm going to activate the new Generative Remove tool, which is represented by the icon furthest to the left along the mode bar. Once I've selected this tool, I need to tap here to enable the new Generative AI Remove mode. And I'll also turn on the Object Aware Selections option. With Object Aware turned on, I'll paint a fast, sloppy brush stroke over the items that I want to remove. You do not want to be too precise when using this tool. In fact, in all of my experiments, I found that I get much better results when I intentionally select a slightly larger area than I really need. But here, I've included some of the beach at the bottom, and there's nothing down there that needs replacing. To fix that, I'm going to activate the Subtract From Mask option, and then I'll paint some of that extra area away. Now that my selection looks good, I'm going to tap on the Apply button. And I'm going to wait for the Generative Remove AI to do its magic. Wow. To see a before and after, I can press and hold on this little eyeball icon up here at the top right corner of the Remove panel. Look at the way that the AI invented pixels that mimic the shape of the waves, and it even created some foam and reflection down there in the wet sand. That's simply amazing, and removing that person from this scene could not have been easier. There's more to learn, though, so let's move on to another example. Here, I have a stock photo that I licensed for this demo. I really like this photo, but I find those bracelets on her wrist distracting. Removing those from this scene is a perfect way to show how artificial intelligence differs from all of the cleanup tools that we've used in the past. If I open up the Remove tool again, and if I turn off Generative AI, then this tool will revert to its older and far less powerful content-aware logic. By the way, this is what will automatically happen to you if you try to use this tool when you're not connected to the internet. Now, if I take the Remove tool in content-aware mode and I paint over those bracelets, then I'll get an awful mess. The problem is that Content Aware tries to hide unwanted objects by copying other parts of our image. And in this case, there is nothing that it can copy that accurately mimics the shape of her wrist. Let me undo that mistake. And this time, let me do the same thing, but with the Remove tool set to the Generative AI mode. Wow. See how the AI figured out that what I'm looking for is a human wrist? That's incredible, and I could stop here, but check this out. If I tap on these little arrows beside the words variation, then we can see the other options that Adobe's AI has also invented for me. Whenever you use this tool, the Generative Remove engine automatically creates three possibilities for you. All of these look pretty good, but I think this one looks the best. Now that you've seen the magic here, let's move on to another example, and let me teach you some useful keyboard shortcuts. When I look at this photo, one of the first things that I notice are the names on top of some of the buildings. I know that those signs are actually part of the Nashville city skyline, but to my eyes, the words like Baker Donaldson are just unnecessary distractions. In the previous examples, I did all of my object removal in a single stroke, But with this kind of scene, I will get better results if I take these words off the building, one section at a time. To zap the most obnoxious sign, I'm going to tap on the letter H on my keyboard. H is the keyboard shortcut for the remove panel. Next, I'm going to make sure that the generative AI mode and object aware are both turned on. And at this point, I'll hold down the command key on my keyboard with one finger. That's on a Mac. PC folks, you hold down the control key on your keyboard. With control held down, I'm going to tap on the addition symbol, the little plus icon, with another finger to zoom in. Here, I'll change my brush size. I can do this either by dragging the size slider up here, or by using the left or right bracket keys on my keyboard. I'll do a little fast painting, and then I'll tap here to decrease the opacity of that red overlay. I'm doing this so that I can see a little bit more of the area that I painted over. The red overlay, by the way, it works fine for me on most images, but you can use this box to change its color if you like. So for cleanup, I can go to subtract mode, and I can paint away some of the excess. Once I've cleaned up the selected area, I can tap on the apply button and get the AI to work. Unlike any other cleanup tool that we've ever seen before, I bet the generative AI here will sense that it's the words that I want it to remove. And as you can see, it created fake bricks that match the underlying wall. With that distraction gone, I'm going to press and hold the spacebar on my keyboard. With the spacebar held down, my cursor will change to the hand tool, and I can use it to reposition the image on my screen. When I let go of the spacebar, the remove tool instantly pops back since it's still my active tool. To get rid of these words, I'm going to reduce the brush size again, and I'll repeat the same process. To temporarily hide the selection ring, which is technically called the tool overlay, I can tap the letter O on my keyboard. Now, we can really see how the AI did at removing those letters, but not altering their surroundings. The initial results are acceptable here, but I'm curious if any of the other variations might be even better. Of course, I can keep cycling through the ones it created by tapping these arrows, but to make it try again, all I have to do is hit this refresh button. I'll admit that I'm being fussy, but I am curious if running this again will give us even better results. In this case, no. That one looks good. Since I'm happy, I'll tap the letter O again to bring the overlay back, and I'll tap the letter H to close the remove panel. Now, to show you a complete before and after, I can zoom back out, and then I'll hold down the backslash key on my keyboard. At this point, I could keep working my way around this image, removing all of the other words, but I think you get the idea. What I want to emphasize before we move on is that this change is non-destructive, and we're still working on my original file. I bring this up because if I decide to change the exposure on this image, or any of the other developed settings, then those changes will be seamlessly added into the generative remove pack that I just created. From a workflow perspective, I think that using generative remove at the beginning of your image processing makes good sense. My advice is to remove everything that needs to go before you crop or work with complex masks, but it's comforting to know that you can tackle this step whenever you want using Lightroom. Let me hop over to our final set of examples and share a couple of additional tips. If I paint over these rocks down here, with the new generative remove tool, and I say apply, then those rocks will completely vanish. And at this point, I'm going to press the letter G for the grid view. Now, I'm going to use the copy and paste edits button to copy the work that I've done on this image onto the next two frames. When this dialog appears, I'll make sure that the remove option is active, and then I'll select the next two photos. With these selected, I'm going to try to use the paste command to apply the generative remove onto these images too. And here's where things get weird. The problem is that Lightroom is not doing a typical copy and paste. The catch is that generative remove happens only in the detail view, and so far, it only works on a single image at a time. Let me show you what I mean. If I select one of these images where the command appears to have failed, and then if I press the letter E to open up the editing panel, then you can see a warning that says some AI settings need to be recomputed. To solve this problem, I need to tap on that update button. I don't think that this is a big problem, but it is a quirk with this new technology that's worth knowing, especially for those of you who like to copy and paste develop settings from one image to another. I hope that you found this deep dive into the new Generative Remove tool useful. If you learned something today, then please leave us a like or a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.